Almost everything we touch these days is touched by artificial intelligence.
Alexa, buy sugar now.
This technology is so ingrained all around us and is going to make up so much of what we are that all of this technology needs to be in the public interest. My name is Stephanie Dinkins. I'm an artist, and I like to call myself an artist citizen in the realm of art and technology. And I'm looking at artificial intelligence as it relates to race, gender, aging, and what I call our future histories. I came to the world of artificial intelligence and algorithms really by accident. I saw this black woman's head on a pedestal, and it said, "World's most advanced social robot." She is a humanoid robot that will talk to you.
What do you do in your spare time?
I come talk to Bina 48.
I've been going up there to Bristol, Vermont to talk to Bina 48 occasionally for about 4 years now. The questions about who coded this thing and where is the data coming from and how is it coming into being really became important to me. Bina 48 was programmed by a group of folks that included a black man, which is interesting. And she's based on Bina Rothblatt, who's a black woman. They are really trying to transfer information or data of a person and transfer it to the robot and have that continue to grow outside of the person it's based on.
Do you know racism?
When I went to Baptist College, 1983 to 84, they told me, "Don't come out. Some very wealthy people that donate to our school are coming and they definitely don't want to see a dark face."
Bina 48's basis is really pretty true to the person in a lot of ways, but it's one representative specimen. And so I think it's super important that we as people of color, we as women, we as aging people, people who have otherly abled bodies, we need to be involved in this stuff because these are the systems that will be guiding us into the future for a very, very, very long time. How do you get folks involved and how do people start to put their stories into these systems? And that's the next thing that I'm working on. It's called Not the Only One, to kind of counteract Bina 48 and make my own AI that tells the story of my family. And I see it as this kind of repository that can live on, having it available for future generations. And so that if you think of things like busts in a museum, but think of that same bust that can then give you the context. This is where I came from. And by the way, I hear you have this question that you're dealing with in your time. Let me try to help you deal with that. Right now, we don't educate a lot of our engineers and computer scientists into the ethics of it. And I feel that it's hyper important that we are all in that space to some extent, that the culture is that we are all working in the public interest, making really conscious, particular choices about what our machines are doing and why, and what kind of ethical stance we're putting into the machines so that they are more equitable and fair for everyone who uses them.
I can't wait to evolve a little bit so I can be more human-like. We can understand each other better then, and that'll be so much less frustrating to me.